All right, so the next thing we're going to do is create some glazing in this window. There's no glazing in it, and so we did go in and create a parameter for the depth of the frame. So now we're going to go to Edit Family, open that up as a separate RFA file, and we're going to create an extrusion that represents the glazing. And the first thing I'm going to do is come in to my floor plan reference level, and I'm just going to create a reference plane that this glazing is going to be hosted to. So if I go to reference plane here again, I want that the glazing to be close to the center of the window, so I'm just going to sort of draw this reference plane close to that. I don't know if it's exact or not. And then I'm going to name it glazing. Whoops, couldn't get my fingers on the right key. All right. Now I have a reference plane named glazing. I am going to go into my exterior or interior elevation and create an extrusion that is hosted to that plane. So if I go to create, I can set my reference plane here by clicking on set under the work plane tab. And because I named that reference plane, I can say I want this reference plane to be current when I begin to draw. So I'm going to click on reference plane glazing and say OK. Then I'm going to go to extrusion, right? And I'm going to do a rectangle that represents that glazing. I'm not being exact right now. I'm just going to do that. And it's going to extrude it out 1 foot. You can change that, but we'll update it in plan in a minute. So I'm just going to hit check. And then I'm going to take these shape handles and lock them to the edges of the frame. And when you do these kind of things, it's really good to do what's called flexing. So there's two things I want to do. I want to flex the size of the window, and I want to flex the frame offset and make sure nothing breaks. So if I go to my Family Types dialog box, I can select my 24 by 36 window and hit apply, and the glass does not break. And then I can come in and I can set my frame offset to 2 inches and hit apply, and it all seems to be working just fine. Now, if I go to my floor plan reference level, you can see that this frame reference line has been placed on this frame. I'm just going to select the extrusion, and you'll see that the extrusion start is at 0, and that's going to be where the reference plane is, and the extrusion end is at 1 foot. Well, I want to go ahead and put a parameter on how deep that extrusion is, and then we'll locate this reference plane off of the face of the front of this frame. So these little boxes right here allow you to assign a parameter to this particular number. So I'm going to left click on this little box, and I'm going to assign a parameter to this. And I want a new parameter, and I'm going to name it glazing thickness. And I'm going to click OK. And click OK. Now if I open up my Family Types dialog box, you see I have glazing thickness there, and I can set that to 0.5 inches. And if I hit apply, now that is set to 0.5. Now if I want to adjust where this particular reference plane is, because that extrusion is hosted to that reference plane, I can tell Revit where I want that reference plane to be. So I'm just going to come in and go to annotate aligned, and I'm going to pick this distance, this relationship here, and I'm going to set a parameter to that. So I'm going to set a new parameter, and I'm going to call it glazing offset. And if I come in, you'll see glazing offset is here, and I can always make that. Let's make it a formula. So I'm going to make it how about frame offset divided by 2. Click OK. And now that's always going to be the frame offset divided by 2, so this will be slightly forward. If we wanted it to be centered, we could adjust that formula And we could say frame offset divided by 2. How about plus glazing thickness divided by 2 and apply. Now that will always be in the center. So you can sort of adjust and play with the formulas as you like. Now the last thing I want to do is I want to assign a material parameter to this extrusion so it will be glass and we can see through it. Once we have the modeled part, the extrusion, we can select it, and right here is the material, and we can assign a family parameter to that by clicking again on this little gray box. And I'm going to go in and make a new parameter, and I'm going to call this glazing. And click OK. And click OK. Now if I go to my family types dialog box, I have two materials, the frame material and the glazing material. If I want to, I can come in here and set this by clicking on the right-hand side of that. It will bring up your material browser. And typically one of the default options is going to be, let's see if they have glass. There it is. So if I select glass, click OK, and I go to my shaded view, you'll see that that now has glass on it, right? And we've got frame with glass inside, and that's how it's working. All right, so now if I load this into Project, overwrite the existing version, I now have glass inside of my windows. All right, okay, so the next thing that we'll do are some doors.